Hello and welcome to another episode of Star Wars Empire at War, where we're continuing to play as a New Republic. Last we left off, we kind of destroyed almost all of the fleets that the Penistar alignment had. We have completely barricaded, and I guess blockaded is the correct term, these two systems. We killed Ardus Kane and his fleet. That means that there's only one real fleet remaining for the Penistar alignment, this one, and it is a big one, 1.2k. They still have 17% of the galactic strength, but I have created an absolutely monster of a Republic fleet right here. I don't think the composition is all that great, but it does have a lot in it. So we'll see how well it does. Nebula class reporting. In fact, you know what? Let's just send in some more stuff. Like, why not? The more the merrier at this point, right? We are getting more Starhawks. We're getting more Dauntless. I think there should be... Yeah, there are a bunch of Dauntless here. Now, not all of them are going to make it in time. We're not going to wait for everything. We're over 2,000. I feel like that's enough. This is going to be an insane battle. We have a lot of different kinds of ships. It is really important that we have this one. At the front... We do need to send it quickly. I'm actually going to save the game right here. We're going to try to complete this.
Sashine cruiser reporting.
Just one episode now.
Reporting.
Yeah, all right, let's go. It's time to attack. Time to try and end the Penistar alignment. It's gonna be a big battle. I'm guessing that just this battle is gonna take like 20 minutes. So that's the thing. As you could see there on the profile picture of the
enemy forces ahead.
There's a very specific hero. Yeah, there he is. Where is he? Emperor Palpatine, right there. Now he is a tier 2 land and space hero. So we do need to kill him as quickly as possible. He is in the Praetor Battlecruiser. Now, they do have a lot of good ships here. We're going to have to do a bunch of damage. I think we might send in the Viscount prototype real quick. There's a specific unit that I want to send in to die for reasons. But I do think we need to kind of soften him up a bit first. So we're going to send in the Viscount prototype. With that Aquarian Corvette. Here we go. The Rakehill. So this ship is going to be really important.
Fallout.
I need to get... Yeah, here we go.
I can do that.
This guy is going to be really important.
Awaiting orders.
All that matters is taking out this as quickly as possible. You're going to move forward. I think that's close enough. We need to do as much damage as possible. Take these out. Let's grab a few repair ships. Until Palpatine is dead, we are actually in a pretty... meh situation. These are taking these out. Palpatine is the most important hero that we need to kill. Once that is done, I think we're in a pretty good spot. I need to move you forward.
We're being targeted. Nowhere to go.
The more damage we do to this Praetor, the better it is, essentially. You just need to move forward because the Rakehill, after death, deals damage to all enemy units in the large area around the ship. We're going to use this to essentially kamikaze a big part of their fleet. Simultaneously, we're going to... Do I have a repair ship here? I do. So we're going to drop in a lot of our reinforcements right here. Let's get an endurance. Try to attack and destroy these. Rakehill is almost gone. The reason I'm trying to destroy this as soon as possible is this is only going to do direct damage. It's not going to do any shield damage, and we need to kill Palpatine as soon as possible. There we go. That's gone. My fighters are doing very poorly. All right, that one's gone. Let's see what happens. On. There we go. Wow. We destroyed a bunch of small ships. We took a lot of damage to those ships there. Viscount, I forgot to put... what do you call it? Like the power to shields. Which a mistake. But I think with this done, we can just kind of power through. Do a bunch of damage to Palpatine. Now he is a tier 2, so even though having him just be weak would maybe be an advantage, 112 supply that can't do anything, I think I would rather actually kill him. Now they have a bunch of small ships that I need to take out. I think the command tier is so powerful that I do not want to let them have it, essentially. Start taking out these smaller ships. You definitely need to take out these smaller ships. They're doing a good job repairing things. Palpatine is doing a lot. This is going to be a brutal battle. We are not going to do well. That is a tragedy, but it is the way it is. Maybe grab a Dauntless here. MC-90 Liberty Cruiser, maybe? Quick as a bastard. Take this out. Palpatine is still alive. Annoying. Does he have a repair ship here somewhere? No. I don't see one anyway. These are quite damaged. This one is almost dead. I need to, like, hunt. Keep killing these. 260. Once that Viscount is down, we're going to grab a bunch of reinforcements. What is this? Just a small ship that's not doing anything. I need to start hunting down these smaller ships. Keep destroying these smaller ships. And yeah, that command tier, I think, is allowing them... I mean, basically, it's a command tier 2 versus a command tier 2. Emperor Palpatine had conquered death through the dark side long ago, yet was unprepared for his demise at Endor. His spirit was adrift before his consciousness returned to a clone on Biss, and the ordeal forced the Emperor to enter a period of convalescence. Not familiar with that word. He was not idle, as this time he was used to prepare his legions and super weapons, while growing even stronger in the dark side through his studies. Now fully recovered, Palpatine aims to subjugate the galaxy once more and usher in the Empire, an empire of darkness across the stars. He is so close to being dead. Come on, man. So close. Just a few more things and he'll be gone. And this is going to be, I think we're going to lose most, if not the entirety of our fleet. We need to kill this leader now after this is gone. Command tier 4, so not nearly as impressive as the tier 2. Come on. So close. Did I just lose the Viscount? I did just lose the Viscount. We're going to move a lot of our ships here. Let's grab this. We need to get some more anti-fighter. Maybe get some of these to get some fighter of our own. Oh, there is some sort of repair stuff there. There we go. Palpatine's gone. Go after that. Yes, sir. Awaiting. All right. Nice. Now, they did just drop in another hero somewhere. Here in the back? Here in the back. Okay, he's tier 5. Far less impressive than the tier 2 and weaker than the tier 4. So I think getting him out will be important. They do have a super star destroyer. We have our own tier 2. The reason I haven't dropped in Akbar yet, even though he's better, is I'm worried that they were hyper velocity kill Akbar if we do bring him in. So Garm Bell Iblis will be our interim commander until he dies, or until I feel like I'm in a position where I do not need to worry. So we're just destroying all of these small ones. A few of you guys just go after these. 264. This is a repair ship, I believe? Yes. So they have a few of their ships there, but not like a massive amount. So we're kind of killing a lot while they have... Oh, look at that. Tier 3. Tenzenkens. He was a fleet admiral in the Imperial Navy and was in command of the Typhoron Sector Fleet. He was assigned the job after the Token System disaster, replacing the old admiral who had allowed significant amounts of the rebels to escape despite the Imperials winning the battle. Tenzenkens was known to be a significant and aggressive admiral, keen on offensive actions and maintaining a high tempo of operations. He commands a Praetor 2. So he is giving a better bonus than the previous ones, which is annoying, but he is 100 supply that's just sitting there. So these two are actually doing nothing. So we're basically fighting a weaker enemy. So my hope is that because we're fighting a reduced enemy, we can just kind of slowly but surely crush him. Let's grab this. And maybe this to kill some stuff. Yeah, so my hope is that I'm just, because I'm fighting such a small portion of their force, I can just kind of kill anything that jumps in. Slowly but surely grinding away their forces, and then once that's done, take out the Valduza type, and then destroy them. That's kind of my thought process right now. And so far, I think I'm being kind of successful. We killed Palpatine, we killed the Praetor 1, I guess it was called, or whatever it was. We have destroyed a lot of their fleet. As long as this ship is here, they cannot put in their SSD. Do they have two of them here? So they have, yeah, Tenzenkens and a Praetor Battlecruiser. So yeah, that's basically their entirety of their fleet. Now, they do have the hypervelocity cannon, which is a problem. Attack. I do think I just need to bite the bullet and move forward. Try to kill this Praetor, then destroy the Valduza-type space station, and maybe the Golan 3. The Golan 3 is not that strong, so maybe I can go after that first. You guys need to pause. This is going to die a bit quicker, though. What does the battle cam have to offer? Absolute insanity. Yeah, this is an amazing battle cam. That's a bit better. Like, if this was it, that would be way better. It's moving forward now. I do want to kill this admiral as soon as possible. The tier 3 is pretty gnarly. We're destroying the Intrepid. And then I guess we'll take out Senkins, and then maybe the Valduza, something like that. I'm in range. If we can kill a Akal Zed as well, that would not hurt. Odds are that they are going to jump in behind my fleet. So what I might try to do is I might actually try to do a bunch of damage to this Intrepid, but then let it live and focus on Tenzgens. And then once Tenzgens is gone, we will do stuff then. Bunch of fighters, which is a shame. Actually start going after, yeah, go after Tenzgens. That one's almost gonna die soon, I think. So just go after Tenzgens. I think I've done enough damage to this to where it's... Well, not quite. Still. I might want to drop stuff in here to try and take that out. Maybe that's a really dumb investment of resources, actually. Do I want a Starhawk in here? I cannot put in the Starhawk. Starhawk here, destroy this, come in from the side, maybe. Kill a bunch of things. Oh, shit. The stupid camera command. Okay, good. We're fine. Okay, now everything start hitting Senkins. And we have a lot more in terms of supply. So get a Starhawk going. We're going to try to take this out because it's doing a bunch of damage. That is unacceptable. Take this out. Grab a Majestic. Or these are... What are they called? Yeah, these are Majestics. An absolutely ridiculous amount of Majestics. Your whole purpose is to take out this. And then once that's gone, take out Zekic. Keep dropping in forces here. I'm kind of lacking in terms of repair ships. We've definitely lost a lot of the ones that we started with. Alright, shooting hypervelocity cannons on me there is completely not really fine. That is unfortunately gone. That is a shame. They're going to drop in a bunch of more ships. Now, I do not know how much more they have. We definitely killed maybe 500 supply, 600 supply, something like that. With the Golem 3 gone, I think we'll be able to take out Zetic or whatever his name was. You definitely need to move forward. That is a requirement. He is taking damage now. That's very good. We're down to 218. Not fantastic. Not loving it. Can we drop anything behind? No. We cannot drop anything behind. Yes, Commander. That's got him. Order confirmed. I can't see him. The lasers are on top. This is almost dead. Once it is. Perfect. I do need to take this hero out as well. Get another Starhawk in. Maybe these are the incorrect shield ships to have. But I think it's kind of fun. Just kill everything that you can. He is taking a bunch of damage. 261. That means that we can send in some more ships. Let's grab a few Majestics. This is probably the most brutal battle. Another hypervelocity shot, probably hitting the Starhawk here. Yes. Grab the Majestic there. We've almost killed the hero, and once he's dead, they're going to lose their tier 3. This guy is getting close to dead as well. They're going to lose their tier 5 at that point. They still have an SSD, I believe, which they cannot drop in until he's dead, but I think getting rid of the command tiers is worth it. I might want to try to get rid of the Validusa type first, though. Maybe. Just maybe. I might actually want to do that. I may as well kill him. Like, there's no reason not to. But you can actually go after that. Fantastic. Yeah, we're taking out the shields. It's still strong. Like, it still has a bunch of hard points, but they're slowly being killed. And more importantly, that's 106 supply that they cannot do anything with. I'm going to lose both the Starhawks. That's just the way it is. You guys can, however, keep hitting him. Because we do want to destroy his fleet eventually. Oh, shit. The Sovereign is only 190? Oh, god damn it. Well, kill this as quickly as possible. I think this one has a... A less powerful design of the Eclipse class intended for mass production once the Reborn Empire's war machine could produce further Star Dreadnoughts. Like the Eclipse, the Sovereign has a powerful modern weaponry with gravity well generators and an axial super laser on par with the Death Star, so it can just wipe out my ships instantly. Not sure why it hasn't used that yet. Maybe the AI doesn't do so for whatever reason. That would be amazing if that is the case. Take out the Valduzia and then start taking this out. Why does it have so much damage? I do not know. I'm losing power. Grab more ships. I'm hit. Encountering resistance. Moving there now, sir. Maximum unit capacity. Yes, sir. They're coming around. We are very close to winning this, though. I think that's basically their last hurrah in terms of... Because it's 210. It's 210. So them not having anything but the Sovereign is 190. Means that this is probably their final ship. And the Validusa is almost gone. There we go. Yes. We're down to just one thing left. Which is the Star Dreadnought. Garmbel Ibis. I am going to drop in Akbar like here or something. I believe we can destroy this ahead of time, and I really want Command Tier 1. I also believe that they are going to try to kill my Bulwarks first, or Starhawks first. So I think it's worth it. So we're going to let some more ships die. Kind of lackluster in terms of SSD. It has a far fewer... It's very cool design, though. But it doesn't have as many batteries. I guess that's why it's 190. I guess its big draw is the... I don't understand. This one have its hard points, but none of its HP? I don't quite understand. Like, am I hallucinating? It looks like it has all of its... different... you know, attack systems, but it says it has almost no HP. Could be an error, though. Anything to help, sir? Once this one is dead, though, we'll be able to drop in Akbar. And we will be dropping in a bunch of big ships here. Well, I do not like it that you're clipping. A lot of these are dying. Speed it through. Good. You're gone. Now. Akbar. He might die. Like, unironically, he just might die. Is this, yeah. Okay, they're not shooting Akbar. Good. Grab these two and kill some of these. Oh, these are my ships. I have a bunch of Majestics that are almost dead. Move them forward. Maybe that will make them attack them. Because they aren't doing much now. I wish there was a kamikaze ability. It would be a little bit too broken, though. What are the names of these ships? The Osprey, the Venture, and the Just Cause. So these two I've had before. Wow. Massive ship. I think this campaign has gone very well. There have been some hiccups. There have been some screw-ups on my part. Enabling Cruel, while it led to some interesting battles, it definitely extended this series by at least 8 or 9 episodes. The goal is to complete it this episode. We'll see how that goes. I mean, we're already 26 minutes in, thereabouts, and this is just the first battle. The Battle of Enthralla is going to be very long as well. I think there are going to be a lot of auto-resolves, though, and the remaining space battles are probably going to be pretty small. So this episode might be an hour long, but I think we'll be able to complete it. Oh, take that out. All right, speed through this. Open fire. Watch that crossfire. Take out their weapon batteries. Open fire. Put your deflectors on. There we go. That is the SSD gone. I've got it lined up. Hold on. Swing around. And we are victorious. We wiped out the Penistar fleet. And with it, Emperor Palpatine is gone. Look at all those ships. We killed a lot of theirs, though. 37 of those, apparently. Okay. We're going to very quickly. Now, as you can see right there... What is this? Kuluda V? Prince Za? Lord Manus? Mod Windcaller? So they... probably switch to a new leader. Where is their commander? I'm unsure. They have a new leader, though. We're going to auto-resolve this, I think. Yeah, we're definitely going to auto-resolve that. Invasion. Cannot be bothered. Yaga Minor has been conquered. Building under construction. And I think with that done, we are immediately going to attack this. Complying with orders.
Reporting. Come on, Chewie.
Come on, Chewie.
Tactical battle imminent.
Yuki?
We've located the enemy.
Now, I know that they have a new leader. I hope he's here in space. He is. Perfect. So... once Palpatine is dead, where is the clown in question? A bunch, didn't I kill him? They got a bunch of different heroes. Prince Sa, Lord Manus, Mod Windcaller, Ghost Dude over there. He's a council member. This Muppet. Where is Jex? Where is, there he is. So this is Karnor Jex, who's a Sith Lord, and he is the new leader of the Empire.
Choose your reinforcements.
No. We are gonna use you, Akbar, but shit. Okay, he's over there. Ah, whatever. Moving to coordinates. And let's grab this. This is our bulwark. I definitely need an interdictor. We're heading there now. Take this out as quickly as possible. This is a tier 5, tier 4. These Muppets, they don't even matter. Maybe I should be going for the smaller ships first. But we've already taken out a lot of the shields. This is the replacement for the Lucre Hulk that I lost. He might die this battle, like his maiden battle. If that's the case, I am sorry. We do have repair ship. I need more repair ships. That is something I definitely need more of. Once this is gone, we'll take this out, then this out. Tier 4, reckless and cowardly. He's taking a lot of damage there. Okay, you're repairing. So you'll try to keep him alive. Where is Akbar? Akbar is over here. It's like this guy is like gunning for him. I do not like that at all. I do not like that at all. You are definitely gonna retreat. This is almost gone. This is almost gone. Yeah, good. Actually, Akbar, you can go in and join the fray here. Yeah, I think that Cheldurat is going to die on his first battle. Whoops. Well, you got to see a bulwark that I commanded for a few seconds before it was destroyed. This is a worthwhile trade, though. I'll trade a bulwark for the entirety of the new Imperial regime. A bit unnecessary on my part, though. Mm-hmm. So he only joins Jax. He does not join Palpatine himself. This is almost gone. This is almost gone. Let's drop in some more ships. We're on our way.
I got one.
They're coming around.
God, I need help.
They are gone. Yes. Akbar is coming in from the rear. I think with this gone, we are basically down to just transport ships and, you know, a small little station. So I may as well just make a cut, honestly. Like, they don't have anything at this point. There we go.
Intercepting.
Swinging around.
I've got him lined up. I'm on
the with Jax dead, the Maw should be given to the Penistar at this point. So let's see. Jax just died. Wait, they have an SSD? Are you kidding me? They were given an additional SSD? Gain Dromel.
Hmm.
I swear to God, these these SSDs keep popping out of the woodwork like crazy. Akbar, definitely retreat from me. Thank you. So I guess this is a problem with going through all these eras, is they're just given SSDs like they're nothing. Kill some of these smaller ships, please. Thank you.
Lost the ion cannons.
Yes, sir.
Our launch bay is gone.
All of these ships that are here are probably just going to die. That is a sacrifice that I was willing to make. Fortunately, we do have quite a bit in terms of forces. We have another Starhawk. Like, this is the... I don't even know what it's called. The Borealis is going to die. The Phalanx is going to die. The Resilience is going to die. The Barracuda is going to die. Corsica is going to die. Endeavor is going to die. I'm sorry, but... You had the unfortunate situation of being one of my ships at the end game where I want to end the episode. I am not going to try to be subtle or try to... I mean, I'm not throwing my soldiers away like they're absolutely nothing, but I will not hesitate to sacrifice to save the galaxy. I'm the good guy in this situation. So I do not know what is the counter towards an SSD. I guess. I think bombers are technically, like, really good against them, at least against the shields. When it comes to the longer stuff, I'm not sure. I think doing something like this is really dumb. You should actually just focus on one side and force it to rotate, probably. So I am sorry, Osprey and Venture, Liberator, Galtine, and Just Cause. Just Cause has survived a lot. Like, we, like you, I recognize that name quite a bit. The Majestic Line here, not doing that well. Let's get a couple MC-90s. We're getting very close to just winning this. This is definitely elongating the episode, though. It's going to be a long episode. But I do want to play as the Pentastar soon. And I think, as things stand, the next series, the Pentastar Alignment, I'm going to be playing the 3.4 version of this mod at that point. So this is the first and last playthrough of this version of the mod, which is, I don't know, both kind of cool and kind of a shame, because I would have liked to see more of what this version had so I could appreciate the differences a bit more. On the flip side, new version is always good. Another SSD gone. Now, at this point, Dala... Well, that's an error. Hello there. Where are you, Dala?
Order.
I guess I'll retreat. Pentastar Alignment has conquered the Maw. All of those heroes are dead. You might be there. Let's grab a Pathfinder. Does it have a ground? It has ground. Shit.
Reporting. Okay.
Enlisting.
Ugh.
Recruiting troops.
I do not know what they have in terms of ground forces.
There they are.
I hope I don't have to move Luke all the way over here. I might have to, though. What is this? It's kind of unimpressive. Well.
Engage. Best possible speed.
We're moving now.
Take us in.
Grab an interdictor. This is very much a completely and utterly new fleet of ships. Like, this is what the new ships look like.
Let's move out. Let's go.
So we're basically fighting pirates. Pirates versus the modern Republic fleet. I kind of dig it. I kind of dig this fleet, actually. There are still some, like, a couple Mon Calamari ships here, or just the one. But otherwise, I think the new Republic ships, the modernized ships, look really good. I'm actually really happy with them. Well, that was the fleet of the Maw. You know, not bad. And then they just spawn in with some Imperial ships. Like, I don't understand. Where are you, Dala? Dala is right there. Over Bastion. I think that is enough. I think I'm going to try to conquer everything before I kill Dala. Because I do not want to fight.
Invasion commencing.
What is the word I'm looking for? I don't feel like fighting. What's his name?
Invasion commencing.
His name is Pellaeon. Gilead Pellaeon.
Constructing.
Pellaeon.
Building under construction.
Okay, we're down to just three systems at this point. Are we grabbing ground forces? We are grabbing ground forces.
Vehicle in production.
Grab some
training
more ground forces.
Troops.
Thank you.
Enlisting soldiers.
All right. Let's
reporting
go
in.
And attack
reporting.
Again, I guess.
Reporting.
Oh, God. We're going to try to kill this.
Tactical battle imminent.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Leave one of these and
reporting.
Go for it.
Reporting.
I should win.
Moving there now.
Construction complete.
I'm unfortunately going to have to fight this battle. Well, unfortunately, it's fine. So I was wondering if the mall was going to bug out forever.
Choose your reinforcements.
I do not know if they would definitely the MC90 in front.
Yes, sir. Get it there now.
Get the this.
We're moving out. How can we
transfer all power to shield?
Get a repair ship, another repair ship. I think we're out DPSing them. But I might still lose the MC Liberty. MC90. The Patriot, actually. Because it doesn't have that much in terms of hull. But we killed one SSD, or one Imperial Star Destroyer. Getting confused here. One of them gone. Two more to go. Two of you are definitely going to go there. I actually think I'm fine. I don't think I'm going to lose any of my big ships. Very cool. They actually shot a lot on my... Yeah, they did a lot of damage to a bunch of different ships. That is another Imperial Star Destroyer gone. I'm very happy that I built this fleet here. Otherwise, they would be able to wreak havoc on this part of space. Getting absolutely dogpiled there. There we go. We are victorious. Cool. Let's switch to regular galactic game speed, please. Thank you. There's no reason to go like to fast galactic game speed, but regular, I think, would be wise.
Reporting in.
Destination acquired.
Question is, will this be enough? Probably if I like commanded the attack, but I don't feel like it.
Unit in production.
Constructing. Beginning construction.
Dala still there? Dala is not there. I do actually want to attack Bastion and kill it. Let's see.
Constructing. Beginning construction.
I don't know. Something like that, maybe.
Reporting.
SSD ahoy, perhaps. Let's grab
complete.
You of you.
Construction complete.
Over. Reporting.
Actually, I don't even... I could just do this.
Best possible speed.
I don't need that fleet there.
Heading out.
Construction over. Complete.
Reporting.
All out. Let's move out.
This is a pretty okay ground force. It's not amazing by any standard.
Invasion commencing.
But I did win. The Maw has been seized. And with it, liberated. Oh, I could actually win now. I could actually declare victory. But that feels a bit anticlimactic at this point. Like, we've gone through so much. I think it's only fair that we conquer everything. Dala, GTFO. You know what? We may as well kill Dala as well. May as well kill Dala as well. Fine. The final big battle, and then Pellaeon is going to come. Is he going to be given two SSDs? I swear to God. He's probably going to be given two SSDs. What level is Dala at? She is tier 3. Aggressive and reckless. That's Dala. You know, just have at it. My own SSD. Has some problems with you, Dala. I'm actually, I don't mind if she retreats. You can retreat, Dala. If you do, however, I'm going to destroy a lot of your shit. Kill this. This. This.
Destroy that launch bay.
See? Your best interest is to retreat, Dala. I will most certainly not destroy some of your ships if you do. Tier 2, right? Yeah, he is tier 2.
The Hero of Endor.
I've got him lined up.
Retreating is in your best interest, Dala. Please retreat. And she's like, nope, I'd rather just die. Well, your wish is my command in that case. No, kill this. I'm taking losses, but it's fine. He's fine. Forward. What is the name of Dala? She caught the eye of Will of Tarkin, and the two became lovers. Ooh, spicy. Now, she famously killed basically all the warlords after Jax died, thereby centralizing, I think, all the Imperial faction underneath her. And then, of course, Pellaeon took over once she died. Well, Dala's dead now. I guess we will be fighting Pellaeon. I don't think they have anything after Pellaeon, so he's going to be the final one. Is he going to be given those two SSDs? I really hope he doesn't get those two SSDs. But maybe. Maybe. Tier 3. The Decurion, what is this one called? Knight Hammer. Can be upgraded to an executor, so we fortunately killed her before she was given. A little bit late for that, Dala. Like, I think you might have wanted to do that a little bit earlier. Just a guess. Alright, sure. Yeah. Now, with that done, there's Pellaeon.
KCB over. Complete.
What do you have? He does not have an SSD. Thank the Lord.
We can do that.
We're going to auto-resolve Bastion. We're going to attack with Akbar once again, maybe?
Construction complete.
And then we're going to end the episode by taking Enthroa. Yay. System conquered. It's a pretty small ground force. Do I want more stuff? I am getting some more stuff.
Constructing.
Training soldiers. Actually, I can get soldiers by itself. Unit in production. Get me the tanks. The tanks. Alright, it's time to kill Pellaeon. This final episode, we went through all the different Imperial arrows. I count that as a victory. I think Pellaeon was probably the best leader, aside from Thrawn, maybe. And even Thrawn had some major problems, like he was a bit too overconfident. Gilead Pellaeon. Yeah, I mean, he is the one who's kind of like compromised a lot.
Order confirmed.
Tried his best to keep the Empire alive, realized that they were not going to become the faction that they used to be. A realist, I would call him. Now, I'm not super familiar with the extended material, so maybe my view of him is completely wrong. But he appears to have been arguably the most realistic, the most tempered, and one of the more... Yeah, so... But Thrawn's death ended that dream. So once Thrawn died, he realized that, you know, the Imperial Remnant was not going to restore the Empire. He just basically had to try to keep what they had alive to the best of their ability. And he actually managed to score some pretty good victories against the New Republic with the two SSDs that he had hidden. So that's why I was worried that he was going to be given those. Okay.
What do you suggest?
That is Pellaeon and his SSD. The final SSD. The final Imperial Star Destroyer remaining. Of our enemies, that is.
I've got him lined up.
Poor Pellaeon. So we went through all the eras in the span of like four cycles, I think, and one episode. I guess that's a fighter hero, so that's why I still won. Wait, where? Where? Enemy fleet approaching where?
Tactical battle imminent.
Oh, that's fine. Okay, so it's time to do the ground battle.
Constructing.
And end the episode. Leia Organa Solo has won.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Course plotted.
It's time. This is going to be a big battle, though. So this is going to be a long episode. Do I want more ground forces? I mean, it wouldn't hurt to have a little bit more. Right? Like,
navigating to
I could do that.
Assault tank reporting for duty.
Get some more assault tanks going.
Moving at full speed now.
Heading out.
Base layout. Complete. Okay, they have everything in the rear with the gear. Assault tanks, they are here. Luke.
Invasion.
It's time. The battle for Enfrala, the final thing we're doing this episode.
Yes.
This might well take an hour or two.
Choose your reinforcements.
Come on, get me
building
this.
Started.
Come on, Chewie.
Heading out.
I'm going to try to get this and grab all my forces there.
I'm with you. You'll find
Run.
A full of surprises.
I am waiting.
We've got him!
Right away.
Send reinforcements!
Stay close to me. May the force be with me.
Kill that, and then try to kill the turret.
Don't underestimate construction complete. Let me help you.
Yes?
Can't Go here. What's here?
Right here, sir.
Oh, something is shooting?
What's on your mind?
Chewie, you're not able to grab this or... No, okay. Fine. Chewie, you are, however, going to run over here. Captain
yeah.
Solo. You're going
to
go here as well.
Ready.
Yeah.
Right.
Hero squad, ahoy.
Got it. Affirmative. How can I help you?
This is getting destroyed, and once that is destroyed, we're going to go there. Try and grab some stuff.
Base is under attack.
Base is under attack. How's Luke doing? He's still alive? Yeah, he's still alive.
I understand.
And he's having fun.
It is about time.
Mara Jade, you are going to run over there. You're going to run over there.
We've secured a build pad.
Commander Skywalker reporting. Where do you need me? Awaiting your signal. Copy.
Any vehicles? Yes. Vehicles. Very good. Keep getting that. I'm going to have to destroy that eventually. I think this is pretty narrow, though. I would rather go in from this angle. So let's grab some troopers, a tank, some more tanks, even more tanks, and another... Yeah, I guess some more Jedi. Thank you.
Ready to roll. Moving out.
Ready to roll. Chewie's having fun.
Unit destroyed.
Chewie's having a lot of fun.
Unit destroyed.
Chewie's having so much fun. Luke, are you still alive? Yes,
mission?
And you're having fun as well. Do I have anything here?
Roger that.
Yes, I do.
Yes, sir.
Please grab that for me, please. Mara Jade. You are most definitely not going to do anything, Mr. Han Solo. Can I grab the... There we go. Assault.
Construction.
Chewie, any vehicles to grab? No. In that case, you're actually going to run.
Skywalker reporting.
There are actually vehicles to grab. Never mind, I was wrong. I'm sorry, Chewie. Go at it.
G2B over. I've got him in my sight.
Transmit the order. May the force be with me.
Although you are actually going to go over here.
Moving ahead.
As are you, Chewie.
Unit.
Yeah, I could definitely use you to get some vehicles, but I'm going to get a healing thing first. Or at the very least, try to give him some healing.
Yes.
What is my next
Mara Jade, how are things going?
Moving.
Not very well. What did I lose? Nothing yet. Luke is having fun. Chewie is still alive. Mara Jade is doing all right. Cool. In that case, you guys can move forward, please. Thank you. Oh, actually, run. Thank you.
Standing by. Attacking.
Stay close to me.
Chewie has almost completely healed up. And once he has... they're running. You don't want me to grab the vehicles? I'm not able to use that, but I am able to grab this. Actually, go after that. Thank you. No.
T2B, copy. And it's charged.
Unit destroyed.
Right behind you.
Oh, cool.
I copy.
Unit destroyed.
All of these forces need to move forward. Luke,
on my way.
Run back.
Right there. Right.
And then here.
Armor standing by.
Where's Chewie? Kill that there. Grab that.
Let me help you.
Is that a Dark Jedi? 1v1 me. And he's dead.
I'll help any way I can.
Chewie's having fun.
Engaging enemy.
We've secured a build pad.
I'm
oh,
here.
You
I
need
go.
To retreat.
I'm under attack. Heading out.
Take it easy.
And Han Solo needs to run as well. Just in case, grab
destination
that.
Received.
How can I help you? Last mistake they'll ever make.
This is a commander, tier 5. Very nice. It's actually doing very well. That's gone now. Perfect. Run here. Actually, I would love to get that. Thank you. Mara Jade. Where is Han Solo? Over there.
Engines primed.
What is it, Commander? I will kill them.
What do you think?
Unit destroyed.
All disabled.
Unit destroyed.
Grab some Jedi, grab some vehicles, grab a tank.
Beginning construction.
Copy.
You are definitely going to go over here.
Skywalker,
Luke, are you having fun?
There,
yes, it seems that you are.
Be right there.
Chewie, I need you to actually heal up. I guess that thing got destroyed, so you may as well just go there.
Entering battlefield.
What is your order? Where is the next target? On my way.
I'll follow
it
your
will
lead.
Be done.
I think I've killed a lot of their stuff at this point. Chewie. Oh, shit. Are they called Candorous tanks? They are named after Candorous, I guess. Candorous Ordo. The coolest of the cool Mandalorians. Honestly, like, the Mandalorians are very hyped up. Boba Fett was cool in certain media, but the Book of Boba sucks. The Mandalorian show was fine for a while. Honest, the only one I like now is Candorous. He is the only one who hasn't been ruined. And I think we won. I forgot to use Control A during a lot of my things. Destroy this. I should, I guess, be aiming against the Penisar Lineman Capital. You could actually run here and grab myself another vehicle if needed.
I'm in this for the money.
They're all here now. Run. Go after the shield generator, please. that, we're going to bombard the tax agency and win the campaign. There's still something left?
I copy.
Oh, there's something here. Troops. Control A. Bombing run. A tax agency. Another one.
Gold squadron commencing,
commencing attack.
Attack.
And with that done, the New Republic has secured the entirety of the galaxy.
System control.
Yeah, there we go. Victory. Congratulations. The Empire has been removed from the galaxy. Kind of anticlimactic without any music or something like a credits system where Corey loses, says like, oh, thank you to the Empire War Expanded team, blah, 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 blah. Huh. Very anticlimactic. But we did win. That was the first Thrawn's Revenge campaign that we did and the final 3.3 version. I will be returning with 3.4, which updates April 2nd, where we will be playing the Penistar alignment. I want to thank everyone so much for watching. It has been a very fun series. There have been some more difficult episodes than others, and maybe I've given the impression that I just want to get this done and I'm not enjoying myself, but I am enjoying myself. It's just that I really want to show so many things at the same time. And this series has been doing very well. My second most watched video was episode 1 of the series. A lot of people have subscribed because of the series, and I hope to continue to deliver more episodes of things that you guys want to see. And I appreciate all the comments, feedback, suggestions, jokes, the battle reports, everything. It's been really fun playing through this and seeing how many people enjoy it. You know, it's very fun. So yeah, I upload content every day of the week. Star Wars 3 times a week, Sundays through Tuesdays, starting with Penistar alignment tomorrow. Subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.